Today we will study about Rachel-Sounder coupling scheme. This scheme is also known as LS coupling scheme or spin orbital coupling scheme. In order to understand this scheme, we will firstly come to the structure of atom. In the structure of atom, there is a nucleus at the center and there are subshells in which electrons are moving around it. A moving electron will have angular momentum, orbital angular momentum. Now the electron also spins around its own axis, so it will have spin angular momentum. The orbital angular momentum is shown by L and the spin angular momentum is shown by S. This is the case of one electron. But when there are more than one electrons, it means in the case of multi-electron system, there will be many electrons and each electron will have orbital angular momentum and spin angular momentum. These are shown by L1, L2, L3 and L4 and the spin angular momentum are shown by S1, S2, S3, S4 and so on. So, in order to understand the energy state of the atom, we will consider the resultant angular momentum. It means there will be coupling of the orbital angular momentum and spin angular momentum. And this resultant angular momentum is shown by J. And the energy state of the atom is shown by a term symbol that is denoted as 2s plus 1 Lj, where the subscript 2s plus 1 shows the multiplicity of that state. L shows the total orbital angular momentum and J shows the resultant angular momentum. L is shown by various letters that are S, P, D, F, where S means 0 orbital, P means 1, D means 2 and F means 3 and so on. So in order to get the term symbol, we will follow the following steps. First step is to determine the total orbital angular momentum. It is got by the vectorial combination of different orbital angular momentum of the electrons. So L will be L1 plus L2, L1 plus L2 minus 1 and so on till L1 minus L2. Let me consider the state P2 where there are two electrons, one in plus 1 orbital and one in 0. So L1 will be 1 and L2 will be 0. So L will be 1 plus 0 and 1 minus 1. We get two states that are 1 and 0. It is denoted by P and S respectively. The next step is to determine the total spin angular momentum. It is shown by vectorial combinations of the spin angular momentum of different electrons and S will be S1 plus S2, S1 plus S2 minus 1 and so on till S1 minus S2. Let me consider the case of P2 state where there are two electrons, both have same spin. It means S1 is plus half and S2 is also plus half. So the vectorial combination will be half plus half, half plus half minus 1 and half minus half. So we get two spin states that are 1 and 0. Now the next step is to determine the total angular momentum. It will be obtained by the vectorial combination of L and S. So J will be L plus S minus 1, L plus S minus 2 and so on till L minus S. Let me consider the case of carbon, where there are 6 electrons and its electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2 and 2p2. Here the outer shell is, in this state there are 2 electrons, 1 in plus 1 and 1 in 0. So L value will be 1 and 0 and S will be plus half and plus half. So the L value we get is 1 and the S value we get is half plus half is equal to 1. So the J value that we get are 1 plus 1, 1 plus 1 minus 1 and 1 minus 1. So J value will be 2, 1 and 0 and the term symbol will be 2s plus 1 Lj. That will get 3 values, 3p2, 3p1 and 3p0, out of which the ground state term symbol will be 3p0. How we determine this? There are rules for determining the ground state term. First rule is the ground state term is one with the maximum spin multiplicity or the maximum number of unpaired electrons. It means the state when there are the number of unpaired electrons is maximum. For example, The three states are 2P, 1P and 3P. Out of which 3P state has the maximum spin multiplicity, so it will be the ground state term. The next rule is if there are more than one terms with same multiplicity, the ground state term is one with the largest L value. For example, if there are two terms 2P and 2D, out of which 2D will be the ground state term. For half filled shell or less than half filled shell, ground state term is 1 with the lowest J value. For example, in carbon there are 2 electrons, so it is less than half filled. And there are 3 terms 3P2, 3P1 and 3P0, out of which ground state term is 3P0. For more than half filled state, ground state term is 1 with the highest J value. For example, in oxygen there are 4 electrons, so it is more than half filled. And it has 3 states 3p2, 3p1 and 3p0, out of which highest J value is 3p2, so it is the ground state term. This is all about Russell-Saunders coupling scheme. If you want to see the examples of this, you can see the another video, that is determination of term symbols. Thank you for watching this video. If you like, please subscribe it.